Okay. How did you get involved with St. Gerard Center for Life? Yeah, when did that all start?
I came from Cuba in 2006, and I had a neighbor, and she took me to a trip, you know, like a tour in Hartford. And she went with me to Central. She needed a formula for the baby, and she said she got everything that she needed there, like Pampers and things for the babies, because she was a single mom and she needed help. And she said that Teresa was a good helper. So I went with her and I met Mary Trini. She became my friend. and we were friends, so we talked.
And at that time you had a daughter.
Yeah, my daughter was 2 years old. I got some Pampers from there too, mm-hmm. for her. So I decided to, you know, go back myself. And I used to go on every Tuesday and meet Mary Trini there. And we have lunch with all the other moms. And my daughter played with all the kids. And it was fun. So I used to go there until I went to college in 2007. So I stopped. I didn't go anymore because I was going to college. When I started the college, Teresa paid my books. I remember she bought my books. I did have like 7 months in the English classes, the ESL classes, and she paid every month. She sent a check to them with the money to pay my books. And then after I finished the college,
When you finished college, what did you get, a certificate or?
Yeah, I do have a I do have a certification and an associate's degree in medical assistant.
Wow.
Yeah, I did that. And I never work because then I start, I went to Cuba after, and then I was pregnant. But then when I met Teresa, in the same year that I went to, to Sandra in 2007, I had a friend that told me to use the Jasmine thing, the medication. Mm-hmm. She said, oh, that's good, your daughter is 2, you can have it for a few years, and then if you decide to have more kids, you can have it. She said, it is good, and I had it for years, and it's perfect. So I started using that, and after the 5 months, I got the blood clots. And then they found out that I had a lupus after I had the surgery, and they told me that I could have any more kids.
So you had surgery for the blood clots?
I do have 2 blood clots in the lungs, and they made me, they gave me the heparin to destroy the clots, and I went to a surgery to get it's called umbrella, it's a blood thinner. And it goes in the pain. It is like in a small umbrella. It opens and closes.
Oh,
it's in the vein, in the heart.
In the vein.
Yeah. And I got it for life. Because they put it there and they tried to remove it after a month. But for some reason it got stuck. So they couldn't remove it. So after that, the doctor told me I couldn't use any other thing with the hormones. So I got the depot shot, and it gave me the hormones, and I got the fat weight. And I got all this dizziness and headache. So I stopped taking that, and I started with the IUD. That it moved, and then I got pregnant. And then when I got pregnant, the doctors told me that I had to abort. They sent me to a clinic because they don't do it in St. Francis. So they sent me to a clinic in the main street, the one on from the Maple. So I did call Mary Trini and told her about it. And she told me to talk to Teresa. And she said that everything was going to be fine. And it was. I had a baby. And the baby's healthy. Yeah. he was a good kid. I never had any problem in the pregnancy. I didn't have any pain at all when I had the delivery. I didn't bleed a lot, like they say. I wasn't in pain. I had a vaginal delivery and I didn't have any problems with the waiting and pains.
And he's your baby, is your baby healthy?
Yeah, he's healthy. And I am too. Not at all. I had the, now I went to the hospital. I do have, they call bladder stones. So the doctor say I collected in the pregnancy.
Gallbladder stones?
Yeah, stones. I didn't hear about that ever in my life. Mm-hmm. Never before. I know you can have the stones in the kidney, but not in the gallbladder thing. Mm-hmm. So I do have to have a surgery. Mm-hmm. But I'm fine. I don't have any problems with the bleeding or anywhere.
And
I'm fine.
What about the lupus? Is that active now, or do you feel okay? Or
I feel okay, but I have to take the blood thinner for life anyways. Mm-hmm. I used, while I was pregnant, I used injections that I did on my own. I had to have the medication twice a day, and then I switched to the Coumadin when I had the baby. Mm-hmm. I'm fine, I don't feel anything. I never knew that I had the lupus because I didn't feel anything before I had the medication for preventing the kids. And the doctor told me that it was the thing that caused the lupus. I had it, but it was there and anybody need, you know, didn't, nobody know it because I had it, like it was hiding.
It was hiding,
yeah.
Yes.
And now I had it because it came up because the preventing kids pill they came.
So
because the hormones.
Mm-hmm. And so now you live in Hartford with your husband and your two children, right?
Yeah. My daughter is 7 and a half, and my husband and I have been together for 12 years now, and we had the baby boy that we always dreamed with.
He's a proud father, that's for sure.
Yeah.
Can I ask you about the faith class that's offered by St. Gerard's? Let's see. I can't say why did you decide to take the faith class. Yeah,
I did. You can ask.
Well, St. Gerard's offers a faith class. It's relatively new, and it's to help the mothers, I guess, come closer to Jesus and His Holy Church by learning about God and His beautiful church. And so can you tell me about the class?
Yeah, I took the class. I came when I was about 5 months pregnant, and then I decided to take the class because I always hear people talking about Jesus, but it's not, they say things that they learn and they say things that they think that I was like that, but it's not the same when you read it like in the Bible or when you have somebody to, who is teaching you how he, you know, he was and what he did. That I have learned many things that he did and I didn't know it because I knew that I know he's dead. But I didn't know that he suffered that much. And he helped me a lot because I can see how, like, I did learn a lot. I told my doctor when he told me that I had to have the shots for
the
whole pregnancy.
In your
Yeah, side. He said, you have to have injections twice a day and it will be painful? Do you think that you can stand that? And I told him, I sure will. Do you hear about Jesus? And he said, yeah, sure. And I say, what? Do you see how he was there and bleeding and in pain? And he even forgave the people for that. And he did everything for us. So why, if he gave me a child, I'm sure that he did it for a purpose. And for some reason, he wanted me to have the child. And he said, yes, but you know you can die. And I say, yeah, I know I can die. But now that I've been in the classes, I learned that if I die, it's because, you know, he wanted me to have the baby before, so I can have my dream, and then I can die because I have what I wanted.
Plus,
so he gave me the child that he knows that I always wanted, and he proved to the other people that I could have it. Because everybody say when you have a lupus, you can't have kids. And I sure did, and I have my child that's healthy, and I'm healthy. So it's not true that you have to have an abortion because of disease. It's not true. Because the baby is healthy. Thank God.
Yes. Thank God. And what I found when I started the faith class, and with you in particular, that you come from a country that the government doesn't believe in God and tries to teach all the people not to believe in God, but there seems to be resistance against that, because wasn't your grandmother Catholic?
Yeah, my grandmother, she's Catholic, and I was baptized when I was a child, and my daughter was too. Before we came from Cuba, mm-hmm. we got baptized. Mm-hmm. She goes to mass every week, like every Sunday she goes to church. And she's 59 years old, and she always has been like that. She got married from, you know, the Catholic Church. And she always have been there, but I think that her family, you know, kind of helped her with that in the past. Mm-hmm. Her mom, the aunt, you know, the family, they used to go to church, because before it was different. Before the new system, like the communism, before that, people had the church before years, like 50 or 60 years ago, I think. Mm-hmm. They had free things, like in here. But after the communism start, they stopped, you know, all the churches and things. But they do have churches, and many people go there, many families. It's not like in here, like everybody believes in God. There is a lot of people that they don't believe in God. Because the communism is something like material. They believe in what they see. And they say that nobody has seen God ever. So that's why they don't believe in God. I don't have to see him. I do believe in him. Because I know he was with me in the whole pregnancy. And I know he was there when I had the baby. And I know he's there every day.